The project is ready to be replicated. Today we are sharing a unique DIY project on a community platform. The project includes interesting features such as fast web interface control, which we will use as a basis for further projects. The lap counter with unique features is a DIY project for model racetracks. It might be worth subscribing to the channel. And we are always happy about likes. The project is mature and ready to be replicated. In addition to the standard functions such as lap times, best lap, average, speed, etc., we implemented unique functions with a real wow factor. The lap counter can be controlled via the web interface or via push buttons, and you can track your race across multiple devices via Wi-Fi. Relays optionally control the power supply to your slots. And there is a special goodie that is one of my favorites. We are measuring the voltage on the tracks in 10 millisecond samples to analyze your driving style and the vehicle's performance. You can use this to improve your lap times and vehicle tuning. That's really a cool feature, isn't it? We are using the serial interface to configure the lap counter and for recording the racing data on a PC. The gadget, comprising a PCB, Arduino code and a stylish 3D printed casing, was developed over a time period of more than 15 months. We built two prototypes, tested a lot, and gradually implemented new interesting features. Finally, the DIY gadget has actually become much more than a lap counter. Just check out the videos linked below. You will also find our GitHub link under the videos. To replicate the gadget, you can use the circuit board we developed and simply load our Arduino code onto the ESP32 based hardware. If you want, you can also print the casing, which also has clever features. The printed circuit for this project is produced in top quality by PCBWay, the sponsor of this video. So, take the easy way with PCBWay. By the way, PCBWay offers many more services that are very interesting. For instance, you could have your casing 3D printed. Just take a look at the company's website. Today, we are uploading our project to the PCBWay community platform, as it is ideal for sharing this project. First, I'm briefly showing the search function. Let's just search for the keywords lap counter and we will immediately find the relevant projects. You can also filter by a category or a country, which I find very useful to get an overview. The platform is really great for anyone who enjoys electronics or 3D printing, because the projects are checked and you can order parts directly in case you want. But maybe you created a project that you would like to share? Let's take a quick look at the process. In the first step, we specify whether it is a PCB or a CNC/3D printing project. We are choosing a PCB project. Then we need to enter a title and select predefined categories that the project fits into. The elevator pitch should generate interest on your project using just one or two sentences. Next, we can already upload the Gerber files for the printed circuit. As a feedback, preview images will appear showing what the PCBs will look like. I added a few high-resolution images showing the finished device, the web interface as well as the hardware and software concept. A bill of materials is helpful for the community that wants to replicate the project. In my case, it is a list of standard components that every electronics hobbyist is familiar with. I just want to mention that there are expert options in case you want to have the PCB professionally assembled. Next, you can specify the software platforms used. For this project, you actually only need the Arduino IDE to load the code onto the ESP32 board. You don't need KiCad or FreeCAD if you want to replicate the project. I'm specifying the programs because I use them to create the Gerber files for the printed circuit and the STL files for 3D printing. If you have any questions about this, write me in the comments. In the next section, we are describing our project and we are adding some links to our YouTube videos. Finally, we can choose some keywords from a list. At the bottom, we can add more links for the code or another project, for example. In our case, I will put a link to a second project where we are sharing the STL files for the 3D printed casing. We can now save the project as a draft or submit it. After submission, we see the status under review. This means that the project is now being reviewed by experts and only released to the community if valid. In my case, I received questions from PCBWay about the bill of material, which I then completed. And this step takes some time, but it is preventing misuse and it is ensuring good quality. As soon as everything is okay, the project will be published so that anyone can find your project on the community platform, even without registering. This is how our PCB project is presented on the platform. It's nicely done, and at the end you can download the Gerber files and the bill of materials if you're logged in. As mentioned before, we created a second project for the STL files. You can find a few selected pictures of the casing parts here, followed by the project description. The STL files are available for download at the bottom. The PCBWay community platform fits perfectly for my purpose because I can share my entire project, including printed circuit, casing and links providing further information. It's really worth using this platform because you can follow other makers, ask questions, and you're even getting benefits when you share projects. Just take a look, there's a lot to discover. Maybe you're looking for projects or want to share some yourself. Maybe our Electronics Unmasked projects are interesting for you. In any case, the platform is easy to use and I'm sure you will like it. Now, stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.